WWDC has just ended, and let's just summarize what they reinvented. WWDC started with a moment of silence for the tragedy happened in Orlando. WatchOS 3 is announced. Now it keeps your favorite apps in its memory so it launches faster. It does the background update so your battery dies faster, and they say it works 7 times faster. So it's fast. Has a new dock and a control center, and now you can scribble, write messages back. Has new watch faces, and if you swipe from one end to the other, you change the face of the watch. Now you can have find friends on your watch. In case of emergency, you can hold down this button and it goes to this new screen. And that screen, if you wait for 3 seconds, it calls 911 or the number according to the country you're in and sends text to your
emergency contacts.
Now with the new activity sharing, you can see how much your friends or family is moving and compared to yourself. And since you're politically correct, you cannot directly call them names, but you can point out the activity and make things awkward. And then they optimize the watch for wheelchair users, so it understands their motion and it can give them better results about their movements. They also introduced Breathe app, so you can do deep breathing. It can remind you to do it every day. It has visuals that you follow along. It also works with haptic feedback. WatchOS 3 is available today for the developers and it's coming out in fall. TVOS got updated. There will be new apps where you'll be able to watch live TV. There's going to be a new remote app for your phone. Now you can ask Siri to search even YouTube videos, or you can ask Siri to tune in to live TV. Now instead of activating services one by one, there's this thing called single sign-on, and using that you'll be able to log in to every service you get. It also has dark mode, and when you download an app to your phone, it downloads the app to Apple TV now. The beta is available for developers today. The full release is gonna come out in fall. OS 10. Now it's called macOS. Yes, that happened. It is called macOS Sierra. Now you can unlock your Mac using your watch or your phone. It has universal clipboard. When you copied something on your iPad, you can paste it on your iMac. When you copy something on your iMac, you can paste it on your iPhone. Now you can even share your desktop in iCloud Drive. And if you want to save space, there's this new feature where it takes your old files and uploads it to iCloud and then get rid of the redundant emails, so you save up a lot of space. Just like how iTunes is deleting songs from your computer. Now you can use Apple Pay to order something on your iMac and approve it on your watch or on your iPhone. A lot of apps now support tabs. For example, when you're in the maps, you can have a couple of tabs of maps. It supports picture in picture. When you're watching a YouTube video, you can just place it on the side of your screen and it stays there while you keep on working. Yes, Siri is finally, I don't know why it wasn't ever in macOS, but now it's in macOS. The beta of macOS Sierra is available today and it's gonna come out in fall. And you can apply for public beta. You can go to beta.apple.com and that's gonna come out in July. Now, iOS 10. Because the Touch ID works so fast, you don't get to see your notifications on the screen. Now it has a new feature called Race to Wake. When you hold your phone up, you see your notifications on the screen. You can clear all your notifications with one touch. Fantastic. While you're in control panel, when you swipe, you go into music. When you're on the main screen, if you slide over, you go into camera, which is very nice. If you swipe left, you go into widgets. 3D touch brings a lot of information without you needing to go into the app. When you squeeze the app, you'll get the information out of it. Siri is now open to developers. And with that, now you can say things like, I wanna text my wife using WeChat or other services. Now, voice over IP calling is gonna look like you're receiving a regular phone call instead of a notification on the screen. Quick type has changed. Now Siri is involved predicting what you're gonna write next. It's called LSTM learning. Siri suggests responses, which is nice for people like me who don't know what to say nicely. For example, when someone asks where you are, it automatically brings up your location so you can send that to them. Also, this is really great for people like me. QuickType now follows your language. So if you're writing in English, it turns itself to English. If you're writing in another language, it turns into that language. Now there's face, object, and scene recognition in photos. There's this new feature called Memories. For example, when you go on a trip, it gathers stuff from that trip and makes a slideshow with the music. Of course, you can tweak that, you can change the mood. Maps has a new design. When you slide from bottom up, it gives you suggestions. Now they added traffic, so it gives you alternative route if there's a lot of traffic on your way. Maps is open to developers as well, which means just in Maps app, you can look up a restaurant, you can reserve a table, you can call an Uber and pay without leaving the Maps app. And music, which was the best part of this keynote, it was fantastic. Apple Music is redesigned. When you go into your app, you see the library first, so you can pick up your music or playlist or songs or artists. And they added lyrics. There's a For You section, which guesses what you would like, so you can discover other bands or other music. Now news! That app you never touch has a new design. Top stories, trending, sports, hand-picked, featured news. And now you can subscribe to National Geographic or New York Times and read it in the app. And it has breaking news notifications. Now there's a new app called Home, which is going to be a combination of all the gadgets you use that supports HomeKit. Works with Siri. It's also in Control Center. It works with your Apple TV, so you don't have to be at home to control it. And it works with the Apple Watch. Phone app got updated. Now your voicemail has transcription. This is great. When you receive a phone call from unknown numbers, now the phone will tell you that it can possibly be a spam call. And they ruined messages. When you send a link to your friend, now it has a preview. Emojis look 3 times bigger. Wait for this. Take a deep breath. Use that breathing app. Just take a deep breath. Now there is emoji predictions. Turns out Kanye was right. What's next? Emoji autocorrect. And when you highlight a text, it shows you words that you can change into emojis. Now when you open up your messages and you want to add something, the camera is already active. There's invisible ink where you send a message to surprise them. And then they swipe on it and then they see the message like, you're pregnant! There are bubble effects, which are cute, and handwritten messages, and it gets full screen effects. Messages are open to developers as well, which means use that breathing app to calm down. There are going to be stickers and anything annoying you can imagine is gonna be in there. Notes! Now you can collaborate on notes. I love this. You can create a note and share it with someone and work on it together. There is split view in Safari for iPad, and iOS 10 is available for developers today. You can sign up for beta that is coming out in July and it's gonna be available in fall. Apple also announced Swift Playgrounds if you want to learn the Swift programming language, which is something I'm gonna look into actually. Looks very interesting. It's a very nice interface to teach you Swift programming. And the keynote ended with Tim Cook giving the peace sign. Well, thank you very much for watching this WWDC 2016 summary. Please hit that subscribe button. I must have a subscribe button somewhere here on the screen. Hit that subscribe button and join the world domination. And let me know what you think about WWDC in the comment section below. And until I see you the next time, take really good care of yourselves. Oh wait, stick around, I'll be reviewing iOS 10 Beta 1. And hoşça kalın!